Now, before part two begins, I caught something at the end of the last video that has me scratching my head. Now, that long touchdown that I scored on, what the hell is the safety doing stopping in the middle of the play? That, to me, is a head scratcher. That, to me, is a problem. Now, we go on with part two.
Texas is set to kick this ball off, and we're just about set to get the second half started. And he got all of this one. Great kick. At the corner. Knocked out of bounds at the 34. Left off now, Aaron Andrews for an update from the sideline.
Brad, I talked to both coaches, and they were pretty happy with how their defenses played in the first half. They'll try to open up their playbooks and try to get a spark. Guys?
This offense will look to improve their results on this series. They'll take over at the 34-yard line. First and 10. He's to the 40. He's tackled at the 44.
He makes the reception. Number two brings him down at the 44-yard line. That makes it first and 10.
He's changing things up. Looks like an option here. And they'll bring him down behind the line.
Nothing doing that time. Defender stayed home. Blocking wasn't there. And down he went.
From their own 41-yard line, second down. On the ground, the tailback. And he picked up almost four on that halfback play. It's getting louder out on the field. Down, the punter comes on the field getting ready to send one off. He gets it away. This is a really nice punt. This one's going to be down to the end zone for a touchback. This drive will start at the 20. First and 10. Taken down as he works the left for a nice game.
That's a gain of 5 on the play. That brings up second and 5.
It's second down, 5 to go. Ball on the 25. That goal back produces the pickup. Danny carried that one for a few yards.
You know, when you have a guy that can grab 5 yards or so consistently, it sure takes some of the pressure off the passing game.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on their own 32. He was under some pressure there.
Sometimes as a quarterback, you have so many things to worry about. What's the coverage, where's the pressure coming from, and so on, that you lose focus at times throwing a catchable ball. Here, he just missed a target.
Wait a minute. Does that mean, was that a fumble?
So it's second and 10, ball on the 32-yard line. They'll go Brown. Nice run there. Tidman picked up seven on the draw.
That's good for a gain of 7 yards. Third down.
So we played three quarters of football, and with one quarter to go, we're in a deadlock.
The score is tied.
Left in the ball game. Just under two to go in the game. First and 10, ball on their own 44. Just under 2 minutes in the game. First down, where to throw? He's on the road! The 20. Touchdown! In the game, scary passes for 100 yards.
This guy's capable of doing this game in and game out. He's that good. A big possession. They have to get the ball in the end zone right here.
And this will be pretty much it for this offense. They need to capitalize on this possession. A little over a minute in the game. First down, look at the throw. Waits. He's brought down in the open field.
Two with the reception. That's a gain of 15 on the play. That makes it first and 10.
Pulls it in. First down. He's not going to bounce.
I'm sure the coaches are going to tell him to calm down and be more careful, because I guarantee you, nobody keeps throwing those passes into the defense like that without making a mistake.
From the 38-yard line, it's first down. Look at the throw. Completes it across the middle. Brought down at the 26-yard line. The Ducks are going to take a timeout, and they've got two remaining. From the 26-yard line, first down. Under a minute left in the game. They'll throw on first down. Incomplete pass.
Number 80 was the intended receiver on the play. That makes it third down. That makes it second and 10.
From the 26-yard line, second down. Under a minute left. Looks to pass. And a nice catch there before he stepped out of bounds.
Reception. That's good for a gain of 13 yards. That makes it first and 10.
It's first down, about 12 yards out. Give the running back an even longer reach.
He knows a run all the way. He got a good jump. Once he got there, he wasn't about to let him slip away either.
Second down, about 12 yards to go. Ball in the 14. Receiver and dropped it.
The pass is incomplete. Number 4 was the intended receiver on the play. Third down.
It's third down and long, and losing by a possession, I would expect them to have to go the air. Is up by a touchdown. There's a very impressive open field tackle. The Ducks call a timeout, and now they got no timeouts left.
On this one, Kurt. You wouldn't figure either team would pull away and it'd go right down to the very end. This was a really exciting matchup. Texas made the plays they had to win this game. And that's what it often comes down to with two evenly matched teams. Whoever comes through in a clutch gets the W.
Alright, folks. Well, that was it for the gameplay footage for NCAA 12. So that was the only full game that I played between, and you know, I'm just coming back from LA, so had a great time. And the major question will be to the people that watch this video: how does it feel? Have you played the demo yourself? Do you think it feels just like last year? Do you think the improvements changed your view on how EA is making their product, how they're looking towards the future? Or are we looking at a broken record again because this has been done before? Well, I know this much. I'm going to keep an open mind. NCAA 12 will be a solid game again this year, but it still has ways to go. Now, like I said before, we wait on the Madden 12 demo. Peace.